Hello, myself Ganesh Agalave, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today, we'll see the psychrometry. In the first session, the psychrometric properties will be studied. Learning objective: at the end of this session, students will be able to elaborate moisture, measure dBT and WBT of moisture, evaluate properties of moisture. So what is the psychrometry? Before studying the psychrometry, we must know the definition of air conditioning. As per ASHRAE, the science in which moist air is cooled or heated, humidified or dehumidified, filtered, and the velocity should be controlled. So if we will be able to control all these parameters in the science, is known as air conditioning. So this is the definition of ASHRAE. Now, in the air conditioning, air is treated, means the psychrometry plays the important role, because the science which deals with study of moist air is known as psychrometry. So here, moist air in the air conditioning is very important. So what is moist air? You think over the composition of atmospheric air. As in the air conditioning, atmospheric air is treated and its properties are changed by the air conditioner. So you must know the composition of atmospheric air. So the mixture of dry air and water vapor is known as moist air. So what is happening here? The atmospheric air is first of all passed through the filter. The unwanted particles will be removed by the filter, such as odor also, and remaining mixture will be of dry air. Dry air here we will call it as a permanent gases, and water vapor, which plays important role in human comfort. So here, as the liquefaction temperature of permanent gases are less than minus 150 degrees Celsius, these permanent gases will remain as it is in the moist air. So variation of water vapor is the main part of the moist air. So moist air, as is the mixture of dry air and water vapor, using the Dalton's law of partial pressure, will get the total atmospheric pressure of that system, air conditioning system, that is the summation of partial pressures of water vapor and dry air. Now here, psychrometric properties are there. In that, main properties are temperature, specific humidity, relative humidity, and enthalpy. We will see step by step these properties in detail. First of all, temperature. In the psychrometry, the moist air will have these three different temperatures. Now, here, to understand these temperatures, to know in detail the temperatures, we must draw the temperature versus entropy diagram, that is TS diagram of the water vapor. It is not for the permanent gases. So, if we will consider simple thermometer, from that we'll be getting the temperature of the surrounding air. So, that temperature is known as dry bulb temperature. So, the temperature indicated by simple thermometer is known as dry bulb temperature. So, here on the TS plot, this is the saturation curve, and if this is the dry bulb temperature, then suppose this state will locate the condition of the water vapor present in the moist air, nothing but surrounding air. Now, we may get saturation pressure by using the steam table. So, corresponding to dry bulb temperature, from the steam table, we will get saturated pressure of that water vapor. Now, next temperature is wet bulb temperature. Now, if this simple thermometer's bulb is wrapped with the wet cloth or the sponge in which continuously water should be present. So the temperature shown by that thermometer is known as wet bulb thermometer. After studying the DPT, I will locate the wet bulb temperature on TS1. Now, next temperature, third type of the temperature is dew point temperature. So consider air conditioning room. In that room, we'll start AC. So what happens? At a constant pressure, the air will be cooled. Air will be cooled, and when it will touch to the saturation vapor curve, the first droplet of water vapor will be obtained. So that particular temperature is known as dew point temperature. So you can see here the dew point temperature. The temperature corresponding to the condensation of water vapor is known as dew point temperature. If we'll use small t for dry bulb temperature, T suffix D for dew point temperature, then it is experimentally found that wet bulb temperature will lie between dry bulb temperature and dew point temperature. Corresponding to dew point temperature, from steam table, we will get water vapor pressure, the partial pressure of water vapor, and we will be using PV dash notation for the pressure, partial pressure of water vapor corresponding to wet bulb temperature. So these are the three temperatures of the moist air. Then next property is the specific humidity. It is also known as humidity ratio or moisture content. Now all the psychrometric properties are evaluated per kg of dry air. So specific humidity is the ratio of mass of vapor in a sample, mass of vapor in a sample to the mass of dry air in that sample at a constant temperature, at same temperature. So the ratio of mass of vapor to mass of air in a given volume of air at a constant temperature is known as specific humidity. Now, as the vapor is treated as a perfect gas, we can use PV is equal to MRT, ideal gas equation. Then substituting that for mass of vapor, we'll be getting PV by VV. Here PV stands for partial pressure of water vapor, volume of that water vapor by RV, gas constant of water vapor, and temperature. So this is nothing but dry bulb temperature divided by mass of air. So PA VA of dry air by RA TA. Here the temperatures are same, will get cancelled. Volume is also same, will also get cancelled. If we'll put the vapor constant and air constant, we'll get the constant 0.622. Then the ratio will be PV by PA. Now here, as we have seen, the atmospheric pressure is the summation of PA plus PV. So instead of PA, I can substitute here P minus PV. So you have to remember this formula. Specific humidity is equal to 0.622 PV by P minus PV. Now, unit will be kilogram of water vapor, as in the numerator we took mass of water vapor per kg of dry air. So this will be the specific humidity of that moist air. Next property is the relative humidity. Now this humidity is to be measured with some reference. So the ratio of mass of water vapor to the mass of water vapor in saturated condition. So mass of vapor in the, suppose at this point MV, to the mass of that vapor but in saturated form is known as relative humidity. Now it will be denoted by phi and the percentage will be available. So all these properties will try to show on the psychrometric chart. Now after studying these psychrometric properties, in next session we'll study the psychrometric chart. Now for properties to study in detail, you can refer these books Refrigeration and Air Conditioning by CP Arora, Micro Hill Publisher, Refrigeration and Air Conditioning by Manohar Prasad, New Age Publisher. So in next session, we will study about the psychrometric chart. Thank you.